Two part budget for all three of you, Josh and Edwin, you guys got your draw, what did that mean, especially with the first win? For the two defensive linemen, what did it mean for you guys to come up and get the disruptor that's more, and just kind of reach out when you have that?
It meant a lot because this is something in practice, we just said, like, forget everything, man, we just gonna get off the ball and just be relentless and chase the ball, and that's what we did. We cut some of the calls down and just played simple football and got off the quarterback, that's all we did, not especially.
And y'all just going down, we just had to play with that relentless effort, and not just worry about making the plays and stats, and then we come to tonight, I think the whole D line and everybody made tremendous plays, DB, linebacker, everybody just played with that effort, and everybody ran to that ball, and that's what happened.
Gonna go in the middle to Liam.
For Edwin, we make the plays on special teams, which we did out there tonight in a more advanced role, come up with the pick, that last time in fourth down, getting a half sack, just how were you feeling tonight, and what was your performance out there?
I was feeling great, you know, we had a great week of practice, so we went at it hard all week, came back Sunday, that Sunday practice got off the game, everybody was kind of hanging their head down, but as soon as we got out there, we picked it up, and the energy changed, we went throughout Friday, so we pushed the offense a lot this week, the offense pushed us a lot this week, so going out there and just being in the place where it was played, it just felt good, so I say it felt good.
Gonna go over there to Ira.
Yeah, Coach pointed out, I think last year, before Monday, Coach Fuller, Coach Cordell, that you know, you really haven't played in a long time, you missed the spring. And in these last couple games, it feels like it's the old Josh, but did you have to shake out more than the rest of the season?
Yeah, man, I missed the whole spring, so it was different. And then I've been playing with the Cavs, so I was talking to my brothers before the Memphis game, and he was like, shit, y'all 0-3, it is what it is, you know? 0-2, it is what it is, and I was like, He just said, take the shit off, and I just took the shit off. I've been playing without the cap, man. It is what it is. I just feel back to myself now. Yeah, I missed all this game, so it was different. You get back and play and say, strike and block with it. I'm back to myself now. I feel good.
Over here to Brendan.
For all of you guys, Edwin, you mentioned that something shifted on Monday with the energy practice. What did shift? Why? And how did that happen for you guys?
I would just say, like, how to do that all week. I said we do have some leaders, like, they lead by example, and always be by their voice. So, we had no time for the change, obviously, we were working right. So, a lot of leaders stepped up and started being more vocal, screaming, like, not screaming, but pushing all the players more. Just making sure we give it our all. I mean, there's little things like, defense, we ran on the field almost every play, but any period we do, competing against the offense or every scout, we ran on the field. So it's just a little thing like that, making sure everybody would take before meeting, just other stuff like that. So I say that really pushed up this week, honestly.
Liam?
I saw you on a couple of those plays where you're talking about the crowd and the ball starts. Just what was the atmosphere like for you guys today on the defense side of the ball?
It was great because I think this is the first time since I've been here just when the offense and the defense didn't allow a touchdown. So that was the main thing I was thinking about the whole game is if they don't score, they don't win. It was a couple times we did give up a couple field goals, but we did get that fixed, and just knowing that the crowd was behind us tonight, and it played a big factor, and I'm thankful for us for doing that tonight, because that did give us a couple things.
Can I go over there to Ira?
Since I'm not going to be PG tonight, people have been talking a lot of shit about you guys as a defensive line since the season started. Like, how did that affect you? Did it motivate you? Did it get you down? How did that affect you?
Just knowing that it's going to be like that. And in this game, just all your life, if you have a chance to go to the next level too, it's like they're gonna be with you when you're up, and they're gonna be against you when you're down. Like tonight, we might get all the praise in the world, but we're not listening to none of that. We just know that we got how many more games, we know how many more games left, and that's our main goal. We don't safety line, we got great DB, great linebacker. We just got to go out there and show it, you know, no talking.
Anything else? Back to Eric.
Anybody who would agree, Coach, we're about to say you guys really work a lot on red zone defense this week. You hold them to two scores and not even get a touchdown in the red zone. What did that do for you guys this week?
It was great for just for our momentum of the game, was just knowing that our defense is. We made a couple of mistakes, but we were playing the lights out. The main thing it was, I felt like when we go and watch this film tonight and tomorrow with Coach, I feel like I don't think it's a play when not one person was at the ball. Even myself, like, that was my biggest thing coming into this week. I feel like my first couple of games, I was able to run to the ball as hard as I can. But tonight, that was my main focus, even with the sacks and stuff like that. But my main focus tonight was just running full speed to the ball, no matter how far it was. And I felt like when you go watch the film, that's going to be the biggest thing that Coach Hood is going to be excited about.
Can I go to Brendan?
Good job, Pat. Can you guys talk about the performance that Edwin had, the spark that he provided for you guys tonight?
I'm going to say it's my favorite because I've been watching him this kid for 2 years, and all he wanted to do was just go out there and make plays for the team. All he told me all the time was, I just want to get out there with y'all boys and just have fun with y'all boys. And all week I've been stressing, just keep going. You're going to get your chance, and when you get your chance, I'll play with you. I mean, he got in and made a pick on his first play in the game. Like, that was one of the biggest turnovers in the game. And it's just knowing I'm happy for him, and he got a long way to go. It's just a big game for him.
And then me, I remember the Georgia Bowl game, just yelling at him on the sideline because he was on the sideline playing. He wasn't in the game, he was over there playing. And I just seen him do a 360, man. I'm proud of him, for real. That's why I tried to be the first one to go over there and congratulate him, man. I just seen this kid do a 360 turn, man. He gave me like Jamie Robinson vibe. He a straight dog, man. Like, I love him.
Good Corey.
And this is for Patrick and Edwin. That last play, I think it was 4th and 16. When you get the call that it's going to be a pressure like that, how much do you think that your coach in that moment decides we're bringing pressure, we're not just rushing forward, we're going to come from different angles? What does that say, I guess, about his belief in y'all and that call that Adam Fuller made?
Just knowing that he believes in us to get the job done, no matter the call, no matter the circumstance, no matter the pressure. Just knowing that was one of our biggest plays for a long time since I've been here. And then when they make him get a chance to go in there and make a play, that's what they do. That's what they all do.
I used to play receiver, so all this distance, I'm usually used to it. But once I got that call, I was ready to keep going. All go, being down on the line, something different. So going and attacking the quarterback, I was on block, came off on block. So I really thought I was on block, but I came off on block. So that's what gave me green light, just to go and attack.
Edwin, on the interception, you ended up in front of him, but I didn't see how you got in front of him. Did you just read the route, or can you tell me what that play?
Well, one of the reps, I think, it was actually like the second play I caught the pick, but like the first play, I think, like the receiver gave me those moves, but at the top of the route, so he got me. So next play I came back, I was like, I'm going to do something different, like slice cut on the route. So I did, and as soon as I did that, he sat down, so I sat down right there.
Jordan?
For Josh and for Patrick, Jay Mack, one of the best running backs in the country, Coach Norvell just said it. What was the key to slowing him down and slowing our entire running game down?
Like I said, we just narrowed our call sheet down, and Coach Adam Fuller just said, D-line go hunt, man. Like, that's what we do. Me, Pat, we bet, man. We feed off each other. You see, I started it off. He came right behind me. It went back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And the rest of the D-line just beat all us, man. You seen Marv came, and you seen Darrell, and you seen Dan and Grady. I'm just proud of everybody, man. So like, it's just, the energy contagious, man, when you see one of your brothers you work so hard with just get the crowd going, man. It's contagious.
Yeah. It was good, because just knowing that if you stop the run, that it would give us the right to go on third downs. And like tonight we had a couple fourth downs. just knowing that we have to earn the right to rush the passer every week. Like, no team can just go and sit there. Like, all four of us just go every play. But they're going to try to run the ball. But once we just trust our training, technique, and off the back, that's what we've been coached to do since I've been here. So, that's all it was.
We good? All right. Thank you.
Appreciate it, guys.